wind down day five here at the 28th Summer University Games in Gwangju. The Universiad flame lit high atop the city. We have women's 3-meter springboard diving finals, as well as the recurve competition in archery. Athletics gets going in the rain here tonight in Gwangju with a shot put in the women's 10,000 meters. We have the men's 25-meter rapid-fire pistol competition, semifinal action in women's football. Three medals in the pool tonight in swimming to be handed out. Judo competition wraps up with the team event for both men and women. And we also have team fencing continuing here from the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center. Women's 3-meter springboard diving here at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. And there you see the dive order. 12 competitors here in the final.
South Korea, 5-1.
Zhang Zhuao Zhui of China. She already won gold in the 1-meter springboard earlier here in Gwangju, but now we'll take a look first at Kim Nam-yi of Korea. Her final dive.
Seven and a half.
Get a good close-up look at it there. She won a silver in the 1-meter springboard already here at Universiad and placed 12th in this event back in Kazan.
Liu, China.
She'll score a 66, and that temporarily puts her in first place. Now Liu Tan of China. This is an inward 2.5 somersault in the pike position. No splash on that entry at all. Very nice dive for
seven
Liu.
And a half. Seven and
overhead
a half.
Look at
seven.
It here.
Seven and a half.
She'll score a 66 as well. That held a degree of difficulty of 3.0. There's Peng Jianfeng. On the men's side, won gold in both the 1 meter and 3 meter springboard competitions. Now here is Zhang. Beautiful entry there on that dive. She's the defending gold medalist from Kazan.
63.0.
And also the defending gold medalist in the 3-meter synchro. Looking to add to her collection here. That was a back 2.5 somersault in the pike position. Degree of difficulty 3.0. She scores a 63 there, but her total of 338.35 blows away the rest of the field. She will win a gold medal. Liu Tan of China takes silver, while Kim Nam-yi of Korea wins the bronze. We're back for more archery competition at the Gwangju International Archery Center. This is the mixed recurve gold medal match between Korea and Chinese Taipei. There you see the Koreans, Lee Sung-yun and Ki Bo-bei. And they are taking on Chinese Taipei's Tan Yating and Wei Chun-heng. Looking now at the fifth set. For Ki, she already won a silver in the recurve women's team competition earlier in the day, while Lee Sun-young did the same on the men's side. He's the number 2 ranked archer in this discipline in the world. Tan for Chinese Taipei won a gold earlier in the women's recurve, and Wei won a silver in the men's. And there you see the final results. Korea wins a gold medal. Chinese Taipei will take silver, while Russia beats Japan to win bronze. Now the men's recurve individual gold medal match. And again, we see Lee Sung-yun, and he will take on Kubon Chan. These two Koreans won gold together in the men's team competition. Kim Woo-jin was the other member of that team. So for Lee, he's seeking his third gold medal of Universiad. For Koo, he is the 9th ranked archer in recurve in the world. As mentioned before, Lee is the number 2 ranked competitor worldwide.
cut, Lee Sung-yun.
And already in the bronze medal match, Kim Woo-jin won 6-2 over Wei Chun-hen. So it will be a Korean sweep. Just a matter of who sits atop the podium. And it will be Lee. He wins 6-0 over Koo to win his third gold here at the World University Games. And there he is again in the top spot here in archery. Now the women take center stage, the individual recurve competition. There's Ki Bo-bae. And she will take on fellow Korean Choi Mi-soon. And for Ki, she is looking for her third medal of the games, her second gold. Of course, we saw moments ago that she won the mixed gold competition. And she and Choi teamed up to win silver in the women's team recurve. We're looking here in the fifth set. It's 5-3 right now, Choi leading. So Ki must win this set to force a shoot-off. In the bronze medal match, Maya Yager of Denmark defeated Seung Mei Chen of China 6-5. And that will tie it up. So it will be a shoot-off. Closest to the middle wins. There's Ki. She's inside the 10. And for Choi, she will not get that close. And Ki will win her third medal of the game, second gold. Choi wins silver. And as mentioned, Maya Yager of Denmark will win the bronze medal. It is the first day of athletics competition. You're looking inside the Gwangju Universiad main stadium. And men's shot put on the schedule here today. There you see the start list for the final. We will start with Alexander Bulanov, his first attempt. And he loves it. The big man's jumping around. He's happy with that one. 19.84 meters. And that will prove to be his best on the day. Now to Andre Gag. Romanian's best so far, 19.75 in his first attempt. This is his sixth and final attempt. He'll get off a really good throw, 19.92 meters. As you can see, there's a driving rain here in Gwangju, making the conditions very difficult for these athletes. There you see the totals for Gag. There are the Indian supporters cheering on Inderjeet Singh. He won a silver at Kazan at Universiade in 2013. This is his final attempt, his best so far, 19.8. And that one, 20.27 meters. The best throw of the day for any competitor, and it's going to be enough to give him a gold medal. There you get another replay of it. Great throw there by Singh in this tough, rainy night. There's Singh congratulated by his fellow competitors. So Inderjeet Singh wins gold. Andre Gag silver. Alexander Bulanov of Russia will win the bronze. And there you get a look at the three medalists. Now to the women's 10,000 meters. And there's the start list. And as we come into the final lap, a healthy lead right there for Alla Kuviatina. She's ahead of her countrywoman, Dulshat Fastlidinova. In third place, just behind there, is Zhang Yingying. Zhang was 16th at the 2008 Summer Olympics in Beijing. And there you see Kolyatina powering her way through the final turn. She is going to win the gold medal going away. Comfortable stride for her as she gets to the finish line. She crosses in a personal best time of 32 minutes, 52.27 seconds. Fastlidinova will take silver. And a season best for Zhang, she will win the bronze medal. And there you see the full final results. Katrina Allison of Canada finishing fourth. And there are the three medalists in the women's 10,000 meters. The men's 25-meter rapid pistol event took place here today in Guangzhou. There you see the start list. And there you get a look first at Nikita Sukhanov of Russia. Two Russians in this final. Sukhanov being one, and then Andrei Shapetkov the other. And there you see Chen Keihan of China. And on the right, shooting right now, that is Jean Quiquempois of France. And another close-up look there at Sukhanov. There are the French fans looking on. There's a close-up look at Chen. The same for Sukhanov, as you get a sense of what these athletes can see looking down the range. And there is Quiquempois. He will bow out, finishing in third spot. That'll leave it to Chen and Sukhanov to see who will walk away with the gold medal. Chen was third at a World Cup event in Fort Benning in the United States last year, while Sukhanov was part of the team that won the 25-meter gold competition earlier in the day. And at the end, it will be Chen defeating Sukhanov to win gold. Quiquempois will win the bronze for France. Women's football quarterfinal action from the Honam University football field. It's Korea versus France. France was second in Group D behind Canada, while Korea finished atop Group A. Korea gets the first chance, though. Lee Jung-yoon with a left foot over the bar. Now France gets the ball into Korean territory, and a great left foot boot there by Clarisse Lebien on that initial pass from Laura Agar, and in the 17th minute, it's 1-0 France. France continues the pressure. It's a nice bicycle kick there into the goal, but it is ruled offside. Valérie Gauvin with the great play. France, though, again into the box. That one's tipped right onto the foot of Laura Agar, and she'll put it past Min Yuk Yong. That goal puts France up 2-0 in the 59th minute. Korea looking to get back in this one. There's a nice header from Lee Gumyan, but it's stopped easily by Amandine Guérin. Now the ball moved ahead, and Kim In-ji is sent in all alone. Slows up here, and then with the right boot, just over the bar. That would have been a huge goal for Korea to get them back into this contest. And there's Lebien, a great save by Min, keeping her team in it. France looks to salt this one away. There's a Rubiot, that one off the bar. That would have likely finished it off. But time winds down on the Koreans. France will advance to the semifinal, the 2-0 victory here over Korea. They will face Japan in the semifinal. Russia will face Canada in the other, while Korea will take on China in the 5-8 classification round. Swimming continues at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. We'll get going tonight with the women's 200-meter breaststroke final. And there you see the start list. In lane four, look for Ryona Aoki of Japan. She finished fourth in a FINA Swimming World Cup event last year in Tokyo. That was a short course event. But right now in first spot, there you see Keiko Fukudome of Japan holding off her teammate Aoki. And she will win gold in third from the Czech Republic, Martina Moravchikova. And there you see Fukudome in a time of 2 minutes 24.92 seconds will win the gold. And there you see the final results here in the women's 200-meter breaststroke.
This concludes the medal awarding ceremony.
We move on now to the men's 100-meter freestyle final. In lane five, that is Henrique D'Souza Martins of Brazil. He won gold in the 50-meter butterfly earlier in the games and also won a silver in the 4x100-meter freestyle relay at the Shenzhen Universiade back in 2011. Also a favorite here, John Conger in lane four of the United States. He already has a gold from the 4x100-meter freestyle relay and a bronze from the 100-meter backstroke here in Guangzhou. And at the turn, it is Conger in first. He is trying to hold off D'Souza Martins. Marco Bellotti of Italy, another one to watch for here. He's in lane three. And as they power their way here to the wall, D'Souza Martins and Conger right close, and D'Souza Martins will touch just ahead. And you can see how excited he is, a time of 48.98 seconds, 4/100ths of a second ahead of Conger. Third place will go to Marco Bellotti, and Seth Stubblefield of the United States finishes fourth. And even a celebratory handshake there from one of the organizing committee members. And there's D'Souza Martins on the top of the podium, much to the delight of his teammates in the crowd. Next up, the women's 100-meter butterfly. Liu Ying of China in lane three won a gold already in the 50-meter fly, where she set a Universiade record. Also had a silver at the 2012 Olympics. And there you see Liu trying to hold off Elena Delito of Italy in lane four, as well as Katerina Listopadova of Slovakia, who was eighth at last year's European Championships. And in lane three, Liu will touch first. Delito of Italy will win a silver medal, and Listopadova of Slovakia the bronze. Liu wins in a time of 57.83 seconds, 46/100ths ahead of Delito. And there are your three medalists in the women's 100-meter butterfly. Judo competition wraps up here on day five, the Yeomju Bitgul Gymnasium in Gwangju. It is the women's and men's team competitions. Here's the gold medal match featuring Korea and Japan. It's a best of five, featuring athletes from various weight classes. Here's Jeong Bokyong of Korea taking on Uchiyo Mako of Japan. And Uchiyo, who won gold in the under 52 kilo class, will win this by ippon to give Japan a 1-0 lead. Now Kim Jandi and Anzu Yamamoto. Kim in white, Yamamoto in blue. And there's another ippon scored for Japan. Yamamoto won bronze in the under 57 kilo class, and she puts them up 2-0. Now to the third boat. This is Bak Ji-yoon taking on Megumi Tsugane. And there's a Wazaari scored by Back. She won a silver in the under 63 kilogram class, falling to Tsugani in the final. But she will get that one. It's now 2-1 Japan. Now Kim Seong-yeon taking on Kazuki Osanai. These two also met in the final. And time runs out. And Kim will win by Shido. We're now knotted at two. So this final bout will decide it all. And it features Kim Min-jeong of Korea and Sarah Asahina of Japan. Another rematch of the gold medal bout in the women's over 78 kilogram class. Asahina won in that contest. And she'll do it again here. She scores the Ippon to win this bout and give Japan the gold in the women's team contest here in judo. And there you get a replay of that Ippon. And there you see the Japanese team, the gold medal winners. Now on to the men's competition. This too features Japan and Korea. Here you see the Koreans in blue, the Japanese in white. First up, it's Sho Tateyama and An Bao. They did meet in the individual competition with Bao winning. He went on to win the gold medal in the under 66 kilogram class. But he falls this time to Tateyama by Yuko. Now Yuji Yamamoto taking on An Chan Grim. These two met in the semifinal in the under 73 kilogram class. An went on to win gold in that competition. Yamamoto won bronze. And winner by two Shidos, it is An. So we're now knotted up at one. Now it's Kenya Kohara and Wang Ki-chun. Wang won silver in the under 81 kilo class, while Kohara won the bronze. The Wazaari is scored by Kohara, and that'll be enough to give him the win in Japan, a 2-1 lead. Korea needs to win this one to stay alive. This is Kenta Nagasawa of Japan taking on Gwak Dong-han of Korea. Gwak won gold in the under 90 kilo class, while Nagasawa won a bronze medal. And the winner by Yuko, it is Nagasawa. So that will give Japan the gold medal, regardless of what happens here in this final bout between Katsuma Ueda and Cho Guam. Cho did win gold in the under 100 kilo class, while Ueda won gold in the open class. And winner by golden point, it's Cho, but it doesn't matter as Japan wins the gold medal 3-2 over Korea. There you see the Japanese medalists. And it's a sweep for the men and women here in team judo competition. As it wraps up judo here at the Yeomju Bitgo Gymnasium for Universiad. In team fencing competition today, we're featuring men's épée, France and Ukraine here in the final. And there you see the Ukrainians and the French foursome. We'll get going here with Yannick Borel and Volodymyr Stankovic. Borel won gold in the individual épée and won gold in the team competition back in Kazan at Universiad in 2013. This French team is certainly heavily favored as they have the gold medalist in Borel, the silver medalist in the individual épée in Virgil Marchal, and then also Alex Fava, who finished 11th. Right now we're looking at Marchal taking on Yuri Taranenko. France would continue to build its lead here in the early going. 2012 right now. This is Barel and Taranenko. And Barel will win that head-to-head matchup 5-4. Now the final duo. This is Yannick Barel and Yann Sick. Sick finished 20th in the individual APE, trying to keep Ukraine in it. 44-29 right now. And that touch there will end it. France with a decisive 45-29 victory over Ukraine. They will win gold, Ukraine silver, and Italy will take the bronze medal in men's team APE. Yannick Barel will take both gold here in the APE competition in Guangzhou, and he helps defend the gold medal that he won in the team competition back in Kazan. Now the women's team foil. France featured here as well, taking on Italy. We'll start with Jeromine Empanyanga taking on Camilla Mancini. Empanyanga won the gold in the individual foil, while Mancini finished 7th in that event. There's a point for the French woman, Empanyanga. And their coaching staff and teammates cheering her on. We're now looking in on Monaco and Yuan. Italy would build a healthy lead here. This is now Camilla Mancini taking on Flora Tran. Later on, Palumbo taking on Yuan, and again Italy with a lead. France trying to stay in it. Now down 37-27. This is Julie Yuan and Camilla Mancini. And the final duo will be Empanyanga taking on Francesca Palumbo. Empanyanga with the task of trying to find a way to get France back into it. Palumbo was 8th in the individual. Won a silver in the team competition back in Kazan. 44-38. And right there, that's the touch they needed. Italy wins a gold medal in the women's team foil. And there you see them celebrating, some tears on the faces of the French team. They will win silver. And the Russian foursome will win the bronze medal.